to be, finally, test riding a Royal Enfield Himalayan. I'm at Blackman Cycle in Emmaus, I don't know how you say the name of this town, Emmaus, Pennsylvania. And it's the 2021 Royal Enfield Himalayan, which I've been looking at for a while. So, going to test ride it. This gentleman on the V-Strom is going to guide me on the test ride. And it's going to be my first time riding a Royal Enfield, anything. And I've sat on these bikes many a time. But going to test ride one, see if I like it. Rode my bike, of course, up 230 some odd miles. All set?
It's a basic bike. There's not too many bells and whistles, all right? You got the on-off, engine cut-off. There's a four-way engine start. High beam, low beam. This has a choke. Shouldn't need it. Turn signals, horn.
Basic.
One down.
Four up. Yep.
Five total.
Brake.
Got it.
I had to ride a bike. It doesn't get more basic than this guy.
That's
rock and roll.
Cool, buddy. Ride safe.
All right.
So don't pass me.
All right, my first motion on a Royal Enfield Himalayan. Whoa, coming off the Kawasaki, it is a little different. Coming off the big Voyager, feet are in real tight in order to get to the brake and everything. Very light machine. Started out in second gear, no issues. Coming out of there, not sure if it has auto turn signals or not, but that signal is on a little bit for me. So, right now, it's going like I'd like it to. My ass is pretty comfy. I'll probably want handlebar riders because I'd like my hands to be out here a little bit. And I see why people get wider bars. Definitely see why people get wider bars on this. Heavy at all, although I am sitting up. It's very reminiscent of riding the KLR 650s. A little bit of an adjustment from the Voyager. I like the feet position. It seems to be very nice. in fourth gear right now. Indicated about 50. I like that sign. I'll see how it does on these twisties. Definitely won't be able to keep up with Bob on this machine, but that's not what I'm buying it for if I do buy it. Auto canceling turn signal, so just looked down, saw the idiot light blinking, and so the idiot shut the light off. Definitely not a deal breaker at all. Feels like standing up. Feels comfortable. Feels pretty comfortable. Really, now that I'm more used to it, they're okay. My hands are in a comfortable position right now. I got it in fifth gear now. That's top gear. I'm only going 45 miles an hour, and it's not lugging. It's not it's going nice. I'm gonna shift down for the corner so I can get some acceleration out of them. Pay attention. Almost missed that he was turning. He knew what gear to be in for that. I didn't. No fair. Brakes on these, and I don't see that complaint. I grabbed the front brake especially, and it seems to grip kind of nice. It's not standy on your front tire to stop you power, but you definitely know you're braking. Are very simple. Speedometer, tachometer, compass, and fuel gauge. Very, very simple.
Got a nice little growl to it. Very forgiving over bumps.
Not bad. It's actually peppier than I was expecting. Smooth. And the brakes are better than I was expecting, because that's what you hear raped online. You're not going to do a stoppy or anything, but not bad. So, I liked it. It was fun. All right. Test ride, Royal Enfield Himalayan in Rock Red, 2021 at Battlefield Harley Davidson, and they have Royal Enfield and Vesuvos and other stuff in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Didn't know they had it, saw the sign. Figured I'd stop in and try another spin on a Hemi. So.
We're going to be doing something somewhere close to what the speed limit is. It's going to be like a 5-mile ride. I'm keeping an eye on my rear view mirror.
Okay.
And, if you got a problem, just try to get my attention with the lights or something.
Got a kid also test riding the 650 twin. He's on a little Honda right now. 650 doesn't sound bad.
see how it goes on the highway. It's going up on US 15, which is four lane divided. Downshift and I still able to hit 70 and still pulling. So